need our support. The flowers are listed there in your bulletins, and we are grateful for all those who gave them in honor and in memory of many of our friends and family members. Christmas Eve will begin at 7:10, and then the regular service at 7:30, and all the different parts are listed there. And we ask that you spread the news to your friends and neighbors. Next Sunday, we'll be in the chapel for the service, and the worship committee will be leading the service. Are there any other announcements this morning?
Thank you.
join in our Christmas litany. O God of life, whose love gave us the baby Jesus,
may your people cherish each other as gifts from God. May we encourage each other, believe in each other, rejoice with each other, and wipe the tears from each other's eyes.
May our life together be woven with gratefulness and praise, with patience and with understanding.
O God, most holy, fill our spirits with faithfulness and commitment.
Fill our hearts with mercy and justice and humility. Fill our souls with wonder at the new birth.
O giver of gifts, who has given us new joys each day, fill our mornings with the sunrise and our darkness with a million stars.
O God of promise, enable us to live out our possibilities because you have sent Jesus.
May we believe in miracles. May we dare to dream dreams. May we find rainbows in our paths. May Christmas be the birth of new life for us. O God of love, hold us all our days. In our Lord's name we ask. Amen.
Passing the peace that comes to sinners through Christ shows our willingness to forgive others and to be forgiven. The peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
Peace be with you.
Registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
And while they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Desert and wilderness time times of our lives and come to the newborn King. And sometimes deep within us is a new conception of wonder. And so we thank you for the ways in which we give birth to your Spirit again and again and again as we love one another and forgive one another. Be with those who are going through difficult times of grief and remembrance, and replace that grief with a remembrance of your glory. We thank you, O Lord, for the ways in which you never leave us alone. You are always beside us. There is nothing too small that does not concern you about our lives, and there is nothing too great that you cannot overcome. For we speak, but do not yet believe, that nothing is impossible for you. Help us to treasure your scriptures in our hearts and to ponder these things, that through our times of prayer, our hearing of your scriptures, our time of fellowship, our time of being with families, and even in our times of haste, that we would see you, see the star, and listen for your voice. Be with Fern and her family as we give thanks for her life, as we realize that the long time of years is a time of letting it go of so many family members and friends, a time of loneliness, a time of solitude, but also a time of great faith as her life bore witness to your presence. And for that, we give you thanks. Through Christ our Lord, who taught us to pray together, saying, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Let us join in our call to stewardship. As you have done to the homeless, you have done as unto Jesus.
As you have done to the poor, you have done as unto the Lord.
All around us, people are hurting, and they need a touch from above.
So we are meant to be heaven's hands and feet to share God's wonderful love.
Let us receive our tithes and offerings and our Christmas joy offering for those in special need in racial ethnic colleges and schools and for retired church workers.
Mm-hmm. Was this great? Well, I guess I've really done it this time. I missed the birth of the Messiah, and I gave away all the treasure I brought for him. I'm just a failure. Achoo!
As some of you may remember, several of us were nominated by Chuck and received the Celtic Cross Award last May. The Celtic Cross Award, to quote the certificate, is awarded for faithful service to youth in Christian ministry. Well, it's conferred by Snyder, given his long history of service to scouting, to the youth of this church, and indeed to countless thousands of youth in this county and around the state.
It's often said in education classes that when push comes to shove, you will teach how you were taught and not how you were taught to teach. The behaviors you see modeled are much stronger than the ones you read about in textbooks. So the best teachers are the ones who have had an excellent role model. For us here, Mr. Snyder is certainly that role model. He constantly demonstrates compassion, humility, service, selflessness, and the art of card sending, in addition to his musicality and biblical knowledge. For more than 30 years, he has been inspiring children and adults in this congregation and across the state to live life in a more Christ-like manner, not only in the way things he teaches in choirs and Sunday school classes, but in the way he lives his life every day. Thank you, Chuck, for the many ways you have shared your myriad of gifts and examples with us all. I look forward to your continued leadership.
May we speak only words of encouragement, hope, and faith,